in the audience, wasn't it? Well, welcome to Video Soul Low Key. What's up, man?
All right, man. How y'all doing?
Good, man.
Help me, Donnie. Help me, Donnie.
Don't look like y'all need any help, man. Y'all get the best in the business. Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis behind you.
Yeah, right you are.
Yeah, well, I'm grateful. Now, two of you are actually staff producers for Flight Time, right?
Blammo.
That would be me and this man.
That's us.
Yeah.
Oh, we do the work
that's
around
us.
There.
Whatever camera.
We also take out the trash and
that camera too. Right there.
Yeah, so you do it all around there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I know how that is, man. I sweep around here myself sometimes.
Hey.
That's the way it is.
Hey.
That's what you got to do when you're trying to get that break, right?
That's right. We clean out trash every now and then around Flight Time.
Well,
you
know, actually,
just to make extra money.
I don't clean out trash. I got this ice cream company, right?
Anyway, so
they don't want to hear about that.
How did y'all hook up with Jam and Terry?
Well, basically, Donnie, what happened was is these two brothers right here were working together as producers back in Kansas City, Missouri. And so Lance went to this Black Music Expo in Minneapolis. You're familiar with that, you know. And so there was a seminar where, you know, Jimmy Jam was on the panel. And Lance got up and said, hey, man, I want a job in a Flight Time jacket. And then Jam was like, okay, well, send me a tape. And so they sent him the tape. And brothers was down on their knees for about a month.
And after that, the phone rang and blammo.
Terry said, hey man, we like y'all stuff. Plane. It was there. And then a few months later, you know, about a year later,
about a year later.
Terry said, brothers need to put together a group. You know, I'm going to say something else. Anyway, so they put together a group.
Don't say that.
And then they called Dre, and they called me, and they called Bone, and boom. November 10th, 1990, Low Key is born.
I say yes.
Yes.
Well, that's pretty quick. I mean, that was not even two full years ago.
Right. It's really seemed like an eternity.
Does it really?
It's the waiting game in this business is so, you know, so tedious, man. I mean, 2 years seems like you know, a millennium, you know.
Yeah.
Hurry up and wait.
Yeah.
But you got so many actors who've been out there waiting for a long time. They would love to be sitting here saying, wow, we only waited 2 years.
Hey,
they've been out there for 15 years waiting.
Yes,
we got some of that behind us.
You know, I mean, as far as like we've been playing together, like the four of us, been playing together for a number of years in an old band back in Kansas
Don't
City.
Tell my ages.
You know, I said for a number of years. See, we were in junior high school.
Here.
Yeah. You know. And so Dre, he also has a lot of experience. So, I mean, it happened fast, you know, but it was a long number of years before we got the break.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And then after you get the break, there's another period of waiting, you know, so which is different than the other waiting, you know. You almost think that the deal was the easy part, you know.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So the first part of the wait is the easiest, as far as you're concerned.
I mean, after you look back,
actually get to Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis.
After you look back, because you go through a different, it's a whole different realm, man. I mean, you know, it's just stuff that you go through. It's like you're growing, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when we used to do it, it was like fun. We always had fun, even though we were like getting dissed and not getting paid, and you know. But when you get into the real arena, you know, it's like people are not really concerned necessarily with you. And I'm not talking about Jimmy and Terry, but I'm just talking about the whole, you know, spectrum of the business. It's like, hurry up and wait, man, you know, we'll get to you, you know. But they fought hard for our project, man, and they made it happen, and here we are.
Word up, man.
Donnie Simpson.
And doing some more waiting. Now you have to wait and see what happens with the records, watch it go up the charts, and every week you're hoping to see make climbs and stuff like
that,
right?
Bullet.
Are you pleased so far, though, with what has happened?
Oh, definitely. We are.
Yeah.
Ecstatic.
It's not a better organization, I think, to be with than Flight Time Perspective right now. Because the thing about it is Perspective, the motto is music from a different perspective.
Mm-hmm.
It really lets you do what you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of record companies like say, oh, what's the latest sound out?
Okay, do that. Yeah, let's do something like that.
It's new, Jack. But these brothers say, look, y'all the creators, do what you want.
Mm-hmm.
Good music lasts.
It is.
You sound like Terry.
Where'd you get that from?
I hang around him quite a bit. Terry Lewis.
Now, Dre, I saw you in the Sounds of Blackness video, right?
Yeah, I was in that video.
Say you was
We
in
affectionately
it.
Like right. to call Dre Mr. Testify.
Mr. Testify Man.
The Testify Man. That's what they call him. Because we had a song that we did, the group Low Key, that we liked
a lot.
Hey. Before, but anyway.
Nice video too.
And we had, I think it was a pretty nice video.
Yeah, that
went along with
it.
It was called Attention, the Shawanda Story. Do you have it? Kick it. Okay. Anyway, since you don't have it.
We got it.
We got it at the house. We look at it out on the bus, okay? Yeah. And, you know, we have a good time. But no, I did the Testify with the Sounds of Blackness, and it just totally overshadowed what we did. Like, Attention to Shawanda's story. It was like, I know you.
That was when he was claiming to be in the Sounds
of Blackness. I was like, how could they know that I'm from Low Key? And they were like, Testify.
Low key is like doors right. out. Yeah. We don't match.
But you know, I was glad to do that. Jam and Lewis, they come into the studio and it was like, Drake, we want you to sing this track.
What about Alexander O'Neal, man?
Oh man, sang all on his album.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of.
What about Karen White?
Sang all on her album. Mm. Come on, man, don't keep talking about me, man. Talk about yourself, guys. You know what I'm saying? We could spend all. You know, this whole interview would be. Just about me, and we don't want that to happen, right? Let's just jump in anytime you like.
We'll let Donnie do his job.
Yeah, okay, Johnny. Yeah. Donnie.
Johnny. Hey, Johnny. You know what
I said Donnie.
I was thinking about Johnny Gill because we've been hanging around him lately. Oh, okay, anyway.
Man.
And Jeff, too.
Oh, boy, you've been hanging around some real sickos, Johnny and Jeff.
Oh man.
Now, hey, Jeff.
Well, let's take a look at the video. And you are in this one. You took a little break from the Sounds of Blackness to do this.
They told me I could, yeah. See, I'm actually a part of both groups. See, I'm a member of both groups.
Oh, I see. You kind of like a utility player.
They still haven't gave me my Grammy yet. I won my Grammy. Okay, we'll talk about that later,
You're about to be out of Low Key in a minute. Keep that up.
I always got the sounds. Fall back.
Oh, well.
All right, let's take a look at Dre and Low Key.
Oh.
And I got a thing for you.
There you go, Donnie.
Come on. You like that?
He's out the
group. He didn't need that.
He's out the group.
I need that. I say yes.
Oh,
It's in this thing. I like that song.
Such a nice song.
It cool is nice. It's called I Got a Thing for You, done by Dre with his background group Low Key.
Bam.
Oh,
that's it. You like that?
Johnny, we're all right.
You're all right. First things first.
America, that's some old. Don't believe it.
Yeah.
Don't believe the hype. This is a group.
Us.
Us five.
As a matter of fact, he's more like Millie Vanilli.
That's a no.
Well,
Millie Vanilli.
He wouldn't even sing.
This is a group, but there's another group called the Sounds of Blackness. It's a lot of them, and I'm a member of that group as well. So, if you don't see me with these guys, you'll see me with the sound.
So we can find you somewhere all the time.
You can find me somewhere.
You're
all
always
time.
Working.
You're
kind of like George Clinton, Bootsy, Funkadelic, whoever's hot.
You
that's
know
where
I'm
you
saying?
Are.
Jammin' Lewis, man, I'm always working. Hey, but you gonna do your show, John. Bonnie. Gonna do your show.
You on the dude's show? Why can't you remember his name? Man, what's wrong with
man,
you?
Donnie, man. Not John.
Donnie, man.
I know him, man. But see, we real cool, and, we joke around with each other like
that. Let him do
it. Okay, go and do your show, Donnie.
It's not easy.
But somebody got to do it, right?
Yeah, somebody's got to do it. Now, do just the two of you produce Low Key, or do all of you produce it together?
Man right here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we do. We both produce it, and all of us write, though.
All right, okay.
Because don't get me talking about me no more. Talk about them. Go ahead, man.
Yeah, it's a great album. You ought to go get it. It's in your record stores now, folks. Ladies and gentlemen,
bam.
Finally.
Go get it. CD, cassette, whatever. Just go buy it.
But it's a lot of the song that we just heard, I Got a Thing for You, is, that's representative of one side of Low Key. But you guys do a lot of different stuff, too. Just hearing that song, you go into the album and say, wow, this is Low Key, too?
Yeah.
Air
yeah.
The question.
Stretch out. Yeah, there goes the question mark.
That's where the name comes from.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's exactly why we put the question mark on the end of
Low
the
key.
Name.
Low key.
Right.
But actually, that's like two sides, really, of Low Key, contained in that one song, because he does like more the character vocals, and I do more the
smooth and debonair.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So he's not really debonair.
It's a little,
He's sexy, man.
He's sexy, man. That's y'all sexy. Call him that, too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well,
justify man, sexy man.
Whatever works.
Yeah, well, I'll whatever works. And I trust that things will keep working for y'all. Good luck to you. Are you going to be working with any other acts on Perspective Records?
Yeah, we did some stuff with Crush. They'll be out soon.
Well, they had that one jam on the Mo Money Sounds.
Yeah, it's a single now.
Oh,
as a matter of fact.
It's a great song.
Yeah, the video's great, too. Y'all going to love it.
Uh-huh.
Crush in the house. How y'all doing?
They bad.
Yeah, and if you just want to hear Low Key some Mo and you just can't, you feel like you just haven't had enough of us, you can get the Mo Money soundtrack and find us on there, too. With Big Daddy Kane on a song called A Job Ain't Nothing But Work.
Work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Working and be working.
Mm-hmm.
You play it, it works.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? So.
Well, we'll be looking for Low Key, your album. We'll be looking for it on the Mo Money soundtrack.
Right.
And we'll also be looking for you on the Sounds of Blackness.
Yes.
Karen White.
See what I'm
Alexander
saying?
O'Neill.
Hey,
whatever
this goes on.
Janet Jackson's coming up. Johnny Gill's happening.
We gonna be all
right. They'll probably have me in the studio with them too.
But they need you.
See,
you are music.
See what I'm saying? I'm Low Key. Well, but these are my boys, so I'm gonna keep them with me.
You're on a thin line.
We gotta go.
You're on your way out of line.
Thanks for coming in, fellas.
Thank
appreciate
you.
It.
Thank you, Donnie. Right. It was our pleasure, man.
Low Key.
Peace.
On the video salon.
Hey,
you can be looking for Andre to go solo by next week, I'm sure.
Anytime. You know what I'm saying?
We'll be back in a couple of minutes.